Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to CineMike. For this episode, I'm going to be reviewing Alien Covenant, the sequel to Prometheus, which itself was a prequel to Alien. These new films explore the origins of not only the xenomorph aliens, but also the engineers whose crashed ship housed the eggs discovered in the first film. I love a lot of movies, but there are a few key ones that made an early impression. Alien is definitely among them. It was more than just your typical creature feature. This one really crawled under the skin. Ridley Scott, he just masterfully built suspense here. By utilizing shadows and atmosphere in the claustrophobic spaces inside the doomed spacecraft, the Nostromo, the xenomorph alien's life cycle is also just really disturbing. And the designs and visuals are just beautifully gothic. Credit is mostly due to H.R. Giger, whose brilliant artwork for the creatures feels straight out of a nightmare. You have iconic moments like when the chestburster first emerges from the great John Hurt, rest in peace by the way. Then you have iconic characters like Sigourney Weaver's Ripley, who is considered to be one of the greatest female heroes of all time. James Cameron's sequel Aliens did an amazing job of continuing the story forward into new territory, rather than just copying what had come before. Aliens was a war movie and made Ripley into a badass action star. And both are classics in their own right. It's just too bad that Alien 3 and Alien Resurrection kind of dropped the ball. Despite some highlights from both films, neither were very satisfying continuations of the story. The Alien franchise then dropped down another level by trying to pair its fan base with the Predator series for the Alien vs. Predator films. It seemed that the series had nowhere left to go. Leave it to time and age to make older filmmakers want to recapture their former glory days. Ridley Scott decided that after 30 years, he wanted to take another crack at the Alien universe with his 2012 film, Prometheus. Fans of the 1979 original were really excited to get Scott back in the director's chair. I was among them. Unfortunately, the end result was a little mixed. Some of the commentary and philosophy was interesting, but the film was narratively a bit of a mess. It posed itself as a prequel to Alien, and yet had hardly anything to do with that movie. The dialogue was flat, and the characters were, for the most part, one-dimensional. Michael Fassbender's David and Noomi Rapace's Shaw being, I think, the only real exceptions. So when it was announced that Ridley Scott planned to continue this story, I felt much less enthusiastic this time around. Now, did they surprise me by making a superior sequel? Well, let me start by saying, don't be fooled by the title and the advertisements. This movie is Prometheus 2. It's not a true Alien movie. Once again, Scott focuses on questions about the origins of life and the meaning of it all, and loses sight of some of the things that made the original Alien film such a classic. It seems that the Xenomorphs, one of the most iconic sci-fi monsters in cinema history, is the least interesting thing to him. They are a pretty small part of this one, though I will admit they are a little bit of a bigger presence here than they were in the last movie. One thing I can pretty much promise you, if you didn't like Prometheus, then you won't like Covenant either. In many ways, this almost feels like a reboot in that it explores the same things. It also brings back some of the weaknesses of its predecessor. The movie in general has the same quality of writing as a standard B-grade horror movie. This one just so happens to have a big budget with admittedly beautiful visuals. I can fault Ridley Scott for a lot of things in this movie, but I can't fault him for how it looks. His use of effects, colors, and light, as they were in Prometheus, are masterfully done here. The frustrating thing, though, is that the storytelling is so repetitive here. Once again, we have another crew with a strong female lead, they again land on an alien planet with a crashed engineer ship, again they are a bunch of complete idiots, it's like none of them have ever seen a horror movie before. The mistakes they make are just really cliché, the kind that are parodied in comedies, like having an alien egg open up and then having a guy dumb enough to hover his face over it to get a closer look. Or being on an alien planet without any precautions for contaminants. Also, again, David is able to manipulate everybody. It's just pretty predictable. Though, I will admit that Michael Fassbender is an element in this that is solid. The opening where he first comes into consciousness with his father, Wayland, played by Guy Pearce, is intriguing. Both this and Prometheus started off with a lot of promise, I'll grant them that. Fassbender really plays two characters this time, with David returning, but he also plays a newer model called Walter, who's been stripped of some of the more human traits that enabled David to go bad. Fassbender masterfully plays both brothers, Walter being likable while David is unnerving and kind of creepy. But they too are ultimately predictably written. Anyone who's ever seen any story with two lookalikes, one good and one bad, should know exactly where this is going. For example, this is very reminiscent of the relationship between Data and his android brother Lore in Star Trek The Next Generation, for those of you that have seen it. But it's been done tons of times before, and the film thinks it's more clever than it really is. I could see the ending coming from so far away. And also, there's the greatest fault of both of these prequels: casting a light on the shadows and removing the mystery of the xenomorph aliens. Nightmares that crawl in the dark are never as scary when you shine a light on them. What made the xenomorphs so terrifying was partly the mystery behind where they came from. And the answers they give in this movie are just not as satisfying as what our own imaginations came up with. There's a lot of beating around the bush, almost 4 hours of it if you count the last movie, to get to the point. And I felt let down. Honestly, I didn't even really find this one all that scary. I guess there's moments where it's unsettling, and of course there's some shock scares, a few bits of suspense and action, but I never really felt scared. I mean, a prequel should enhance your enjoyment of the original story, and really, these new films, they just don't do that for me. And continuity is also really confusing in this series. There's just so many different things that don't add up to what's already been established. If Prometheus and Covenant were a separate franchise, then I could see myself enjoying them more. Well, except I think that this film resolves a few threads left over from Prometheus in pretty unsatisfying ways. That said, I don't think that they are terrible films. I mean, I gave a few compliments already, but also the cast in both are pretty good, and I think they do the best that they can with what they have to work with. In this one, you have Katherine Watterson and Billy Crudup, who are both pretty decent. Danny McBride's even able to be taken somewhat seriously, surprisingly. Though, there is one really bizarre casting choice. They have James Franco as a character who is on screen for barely a minute. And he is someone that I felt really taken out with. So in the end, if you are able to view this film and its predecessor as a separate franchise from Alien, then maybe you could take some enjoyment out of it. I am unable to do that. I am a hardcore Alien fan, and I find these movies frustrating and somewhat disappointing. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the very best that this particular film could be for me, I think that I would have to give Alien Covenant a 6. I really would have preferred to see the Neil Blomkamp Alien movie. And oh, that's right, for those of you that didn't know, the director behind District 9 was going to direct the next Alien movie. I think the plan was to ignore the continuity after Alien 3 and have the story bring back Ripley and Michael Biehn's Hicks. And I was super excited, as I was never really a fan of where the story went after the second movie. Then Ridley Scott stepped in and blew up the train tracks by saying that Blomkamp couldn't make an Alien film while he was planning his Prometheus sequel. So from the get-go for Covenant, I guess I wasn't really on board with it. I mean, which sounds better? The sequel to two iconic classics, or the sequel to a prequel to two iconic classics? I mean, you know? And that's all I've got for you this time. Click like if you enjoyed the video, and please feel free to comment below. Tell me if you agree or disagree with me, and I of course welcome you to subscribe to the channel. So until next time, this is Mike, signing off.